Greetings friends, today we're going to learn about changing passwords in our Django account. As we all know that the admin panel provided to us by Django allows us to perform CRUD operations on our web app. However, many of you must think that how can we change the passwords that we have in our admin panel? Well, in case that you have forgotten your password and you wish to change it, it's a different matter. But if you remember the password and want to change it, this lecture is the place for it. So let's see how this can be done. I've prepared this Change Password Django app with a password manager app in it. How this thing works is this. We have this app with the following URL codes. The first one is of course admin and the next one is change password. Now let's see how this thing works. As we can see that initially change password app opens this form. When we were to put our current password and then enter the new password and then confirm it, this app will change the password for us. How this thing works is in this way. If the request made is not post, then a form is created using password change form. This password change form can be imported from the auth.forms from django.contrib library. Here we will use the request.user to create the form, as we will need to provide a username so that we can tell the app which account we wish to change the password for. The next thing that we will do is render the changepassword.html file and pass the form that we created earlier in the context. The changepassword.html is simply a HTML file in which I have rendered this form here along with the CSRF token. Now let's see how this thing works. Let's create a user. I'll use the python manage.py create super user command to create it. Let's create a username abc and the email address I'll use u.g. Let's just put any random email address. The password will be let's just keep it password. And with that, our password has been created. Now let's go back to our app and see how this thing plays out. One thing that you guys must have noticed is that we haven't yet logged into our app. So let's do that first. I'll simply open the admin panel. Oh, we are already logged in. Let's just log in once again. As we can see that we have logged in to our account, let's refresh it once again and then enter the password, that is of course password in the block letters. We want to create a new password, but one thing that you need to keep in mind that these parameters should be met, otherwise the password will be rejected. So let's just generate a random password using the internet, and we have to create a 8-letter long password, and I'll simply generate a password. Let's just copy it and paste it here and save changes. As we can see that the password has been changed successfully. As it turns out, the form was of course refreshed, and we only changed the password of the user that we had logged in. And we were successfully able to log in to the account. One thing that you guys must have noticed is that I had to log in once again after changing the password. This was because if by any chance you want that after changing password your account is still logged in, you can simply add this command update session auth hash. This will allow you to stay logged in even when the password is saved. Now let's just see how we achieve this. When a post request was made by the form, what happened was we created a form object using the password change form where the user was request.user and the data that we used was from the form in the form of request.post. If the form was valid, we will simply save the form, saving the changes in the database. If this update session auth hash is used, the user will be logged in without entering the password once again. However, if we were to comment this, we will have to log in to our account once again. Let's just keep it for now. After that, I'll simply return a redirect object to the admin. If by any chance there was an error, then the following message error will be flashed in the admin panel. And I will simply redirect myself to the change password page. Now let's just check this update session auth hash once again. I of course still have the password in my clipboard, so I'll simply copy it. After that, I'll simply generate another password. And I'll copy it once again. Now let's enter the password here and save the changes. As we can see, this time we didn't have to log in again because we had used this update session auth hash. With that, I will end today's lecture. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.